Okay, good morning, Saturday, 14th of July. We are still in Turkmenistan. This will be our last day in Turkmenistan. First, today we are going to a place called Turkmenabat, and then after that, Farap, where we'll cross the border to Uzbekistan. So, and then we're back on the bikes again. We are on our own, see if we can cope without a guide. So, then we'll go to a hotel, hopefully tonight in Uzbekistan. It's about 20 kilometers from the border. So, you ready to get in the bus?
Yes, all packed.
Ready to get in the bus, Jamie?
Yay!
Oh, Jamie's there. What's Jamie been doing the last 2 days in the hotels? Is there anything here that you like?
Swimming pool.
Was there a swimming pool?
Yay, and you can hop in the water with dip. So you can hop, look like this. Yeah. And make big splashes.
Both the hotels here have had swimming pools, so that was good for Jamie. So, okay.
I've never expected that.
No, we didn't think about that, did
we? I think Turkmenistan was where they was living in set houses and living in tents.
Tent. Yeah. We saw some camels yesterday though, didn't we? Yeah. So, okay. We'll get back out there. That's the town of Mary there. Back in the minibus. You ready to go?
Yes.
Yeah,
okay, let's go.
Just a little funny thing when we came to Turkmenistan the first night. Because in Iran, we couldn't get money out of no cash point. We had to have cash with us and then change into to their money. And we heard it's the same in Uzbekistan. So when we came to the first hotel in Turkmenistan, then Andrew asked the guide, can we change money here in the hotel? And she asked hotel staff and they said no. And then we were standing there thinking, oh no, we need some of their money. And then she said, well, there's a cash point right there. You can just get money out with your Visa card. And, oh, we forgot that that was possible. So that was quite funny. One of the main attractions here in Turkmenistan, which we unfortunately are not going to see, is a gas crater, which are burning. They found gas somewhere many years ago, and the gas started leaking out of the ground and polluting the people living nearby. So the people there that was digging out thought, oh, we'll just light it and then it'll burn out within a few days and problem solved. And now nearly 50 years later, it's still burning. And people come to Turkmenistan just to see that.
Okay, so this will be the last minibus ride in Turkmenistan. Leave here now. Let's go to the border of Uzbekistan. We're just on the outskirts now of Mary. Now we're coming into desert area now. The sand dunes there.
And here we will only see towns which there are some small towns or villages, I think.
Fancy here. We've just been to the toilet here. Yeah, but okay, we cope with that as well. Let's see if we can close the door. No. Oh.
Well, this is a local coffee shop here in the middle of the desert. We're at 42 degrees now, so it's nice to be in an air-conditioned minibus. Not sure how we're going to cope in the next few days. We're crossing the road here. Okay, so now we're in Turkmenabat. This will be the last town here that we see in Turkmenistan. Just going to have some lunch now in this cafe Caravan Sarai on the Silk Road here. And then after we've had lunch here, we'll go to the border of Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, a place called Farap. So we'll see if that goes okay.
Come to this nice restaurant here, Caravan Sarai restaurant, with little camels.
Silk Road Monument, okay.
Yep.
Oh.
Nice.
So this is the biggest river here in Turkmenistan, Amudarya, just before the border of Uzbekistan.
Okay, we are back on the bikes, finally.
And we are in Uzbekistan now.
Uzbekistan, can you believe that? Look at the signpost behind us. Bishkek, Dushanbe, major towns on the Silk Road. Oh dear. Can't believe we're actually on the bikes again.
We are Uzbekistan, and it's a long way from Denmark.
Very long way.
And extremely hot, but we'll see if we can cope with the bike slowly.
Yeah.
Very hot.
So it's 5 o'clock in the afternoon here. It's 42, 43 degrees in the desert here. So we've got about 20 kilometers to do to find a hotel. So we'll just take it slow. And then we have to make a plan, I think, tomorrow, how we cope with the heat here. Maybe get up early and bike till lunchtime. We'll see. But now we've got to Uzbekistan. It's been, what, 14 days or so in Iran and 2 days in Turkmenistan, and now we're here. Whew, great. So let's do a bit of rolling now on the bikes. We are back on Facebook hopefully tonight. So let's get going.
I have very shaky legs again. I feel very strange, the same way as I did when we crossed from the heat in Armenia to the border of Iran, and I feel the same again, so I don't know whether it's a crossing that makes me nervous, even though I think I'm not nervous, or it's just the heat. We'll have to see if I can get used to it. It's a very strange feeling in the body.
Okay, just done 10 kilometers, our first 10 kilometers on the bike in 42 degree heat through the last bit of desert here, and it is
actually worse than expected. It is not nice. It seems very strange now why we ever have been able to bike 80 kilometers a day and bike up a mountain. This is now we are struggling just to bike 10 kilometers. We have stopped 20 times, I think. It is awful.
Yeah. We've got about 10 kilometers to do and we should be at a hotel. Let's hope they have a room. And we should be in a couple of kilometers, be out of the desert. Should be a little bit more green. So, shall we roll on a little bit more?
We'll try and see if we can bike 1.5 kilometers.
Oh, the heat. I think from now on we have to bike really early in the morning. It's impossible to ride in this heat. Okay, let's get going. So, this is desert biking. A little bit greener and greener now though. We'll come out of the Turkmenistan desert here. Okay, it seems to be a little bit cooler now. The first hour was horrendous. Any way to describe it is, you're cooking your Sunday roast and you open the oven door and the blast of hot air that hits you for a few seconds, just like that, constantly here on your face, hot air. Now it's cooled down a bit after we sat in the shade for a while, so I need a new strategy, I think, for tackling the heat. It's going to be very early mornings or in the evening riding, I think, from now on. Let's see when we get to the hotel, we make a new plan. Been here 2 hours already, non-stop cars, papping, waving, smiling people. Funny, we didn't get that in Turkmenistan, but nobody really paid any interest in us really. But even though it's supposed to be a Muslim country, it really didn't feel like we was in a Muslim country. A lot of people drinking beer, lots of beer actually. And but here, yeah, back to the friendly, warm faces straight away. A little bit strange, really. We can change so quickly.
Wedding going on here at the hotel we turned up at. Let's hope there's a room.
Okay, just turned up here. Gold Star Hotel. This will be our first hotel in Uzbekistan. So, just on the bikes, the first time we've been on the bikes now for what, 16 days or something like that? So, that was, what, 20 kilometers we did, but the first 10 was just through a hot desert, 42 degrees with headwind. So we had enough water though, so we just took it slowly and we stopped every couple of kilometers. So takes a bit of getting used to though, that heat, especially it was in the afternoon because of the time we crossed the border, the time they dropped us off in the minibus. Then it was 2 o'clock or so, and by the time we got through the border it was 4 o'clock, so we ended up cycling in the afternoon heat here through the desert. But now we're here, turned up here, just had a glass of cold water. But the last era wasn't too bad. It cooled down a bit after we had a rest under the tree, and it went okay really. So now we're here. Yeah. So far people seem friendly here in Uzbekistan, that's the most important. I don't speak English though, Russian I think I speak here. But good to be back on the bikes. Let's see how we cope with the heat, make a plan for that. Okay, see you later. Okay, so now we're in Uzbekistan. This is our first restaurant here. So we just had to change some money in the shop here, and then they've got a restaurant at the back of the shop. So there's no cash points here in Uzbekistan, so you have to change dollars into Uzbekistan, whatever it is, I'm not sure yet. Now we got some chicken here.
Okay, now I want to tell how Uzbekistan is called. Uzbekistan, is that correct?
Mm.
Uzbekistan cups and European cups. This is a European cup, you know, where you drink a glass. But here in Uzbekistan, you need to have a cup that you want to eat with in your breakfast with your cereals. So that is where.
Okay, we managed to change some money in the local tiny shop and get some food. And 2 bottles of Fanta and 2 bottles of water. So now we're rehydrated. But we crossed the border today. Went okay actually. We had to show our passport, I don't know, 6-7 times. But went okay. Fill in a declaration form to say what you... Oh, whether you're taking it out or taking it in, really, it was on the Turkmenistan side. But,
apart from that, it was fairly easy. Andrew had read on the internet about other people that had problems, and it took a long time to get through on that. But could be it was old stories, but of course, it seemed very modern and easy and civilized.
Yeah, very modern as well. Yeah, I've heard people having to wait 5 hours and paying bribes to Russian soldiers, but. None of that here. It was really well organized and nice building, so no problems at all. Now we're in Uzbekistan, land of smiling faces, we've just seen already. It's funny, you wouldn't go over a border and the people change and their attitude changes too. So yeah, that's it. I think we're gonna have a rest here tomorrow. Maybe we'll do a looking back at Iran and Turkmenistan video. We haven't actually had time to do that yet.
But,
and now we're on our own again, just the three of us. Hi, Jamie's here. No guide. We can...
Let's see if we can cope on our own.
Yes, see if we can.
The guide here is me.
Good guide.
Because I'm look more to... How do you say? What is the country?
Yeah, you look like Uzbekistan. An Uzbek. Yeah.
And many people say, you are from Turkmenistan. I'm saying, I'm from South America. And they begin again and again.
So that's it. So resting day I think tomorrow. Catch up with everything we haven't caught up with. So.
Yes. Also because we are not ready to bike 5 o'clock in the morning, and
no.
Apparently we cannot bike in the afternoon.
Gotta get up very early to bike here. Even though it's, I don't know, 10 o'clock. It's roasting hot.
Yes.
So
now we're going to our air conditioned room.
Yep. Sit there.
We'll probably never get the tent out again. I'm worried.
So it'll be okay. But yep, we need to stop waffling now. We need to
go to bed.
Go to bed. And then tomorrow we'll make a plan on how we get to Bukhara. And Bukhara is 80 kilometers away. And that's the big destination there. When we get there, then we're having a 2 or 3 day break, I think. So, okay, let's go.
Good night.
And have a rest.
Good night.
Okay, good night.